Hi. In this question, we're looking at this problem involving linear independence over a space of polynomials. We're working in P2, which is a space of polynomials of degree 2 or less, over R. And we're asked whether these three polynomials here are linearly independent. And if they're not linearly independent, to express one of them as a linear combination of the others. Okay, so we need to look at, we need to solve the equation that say a 1 minus x plus 2x squared plus b minus 1 plus x squared plus c minus 2 minus x plus 5x squared equals 0. And 0 in this context is the 0 polynomial. 0 plus 0x plus 0x squared and so on. So we need to solve this for a, b, and c. Okay, so there's actually three equations here. This gives three equations. Namely, the constant term is a minus b minus 2c. That should equal 0. The linear term, all the powers of x, is minus a plus 0 b and minus c x should also equal 0, the coefficient of x on the right hand side. And the coefficient of x squared would be 2a here plus b plus 5c equals 0. So we want to solve this system of linear equations for a, b, and c. If the only solution is a equals b equals c equals 0, then the three polynomials are linearly independent. Notice that this is a homogeneous system because the right-hand side entries are all 0. Okay, so the augmented matrix is, let's go over here, so 1 minus 1 minus 2 minus 1 0 minus 1 2 1 5 and row of zeros on the right hand side. All right, let's row reduce. So let's take row 2 will be row 2 plus row 1, and row 3 will be row 3 minus 2 times row 1. So we'll leave the first row where it is, 1 minus 1 minus 2, 0. Take the second row and add to it the first row. And we'll take the third row and subtract 2 times the first row. 0. 1 minus 2 times this is 3. 5 minus 2 times this is 9. And zeros on the other side. And now we're going to use this as a pivot. Get rid of the 3 below it. So we'll replace row 3 with row 3 plus 3 times row 2. Giving us 1 minus 1 minus 2. 0 minus 1 minus 3, 0. And this plus 3 times the previous row gives us a row of zeros. It's now in row echelon form, and we can see that, in fact, there are solutions. How do we know that? There are solutions because here are the leading entries, here are the leading columns, and there is one non-leading column. The one non-leading column means that there's a parameter of... The non-leading column tells us that there is a one-parameter family of solutions. So in particular, we know that these three polynomials are not linearly independent. But let's just go a little bit further and actually find the solutions. So for that, we're going to fully reduce this. We're going to go a little bit further. First of all, I'm going to multiply the second row just with minus 1, so we have a 1 there. And then I'm going to take this leading entry and use it to eliminate the entry above it. So we're going to take row 1 is row 1 plus row 2. We're going to add row 2 to row 1. That'll give us 1, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 1, 3, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, now it's in completely or fully reduced row echelon form, and we can more or less read off solutions. So how do we read off solutions? Well, remember our variables are A, B, and C. So we can set C equal to some parameter lambda. And then in terms of that lambda, A will be equal to minus lambda. And from the second one, B will be equal to minus 3 lambda. So therefore we get that A, B, and C are lambda times minus 1, minus 3, and 1. So to conclude, therefore the set is not linearly independent. It's not linearly independent. And in fact, a relation is given by these things here. So if we want to express that as a relation, we could say, that minus the first one plus minus 3 times the second one plus 1 times the third is going to be 0. In fact, we have a solution that minus 1 times 1 minus x plus 2x squared minus 3 times the second one minus 1 plus x squared and plus 1 times the last one minus 2 minus x plus 5x squared, that's actually equal to 0. So there's a linear relation between these three polynomials exhibiting that they are not linearly independent. And if we actually want to write one of them as a linear combination of the other, it's just a question of moving one of these to the other side. So let's move this one to the other side. So therefore, for example, we could write 1 minus x plus 2x squared equals, this is on the other side, so minus 3 times this one, minus 3 times minus 1 plus x squared plus the second one, minus 2 minus x plus 5x squared. Okay, that's a relation that's satisfied expressing one of the polynomials as a linear combination of the other two.